What is up? It's your girl Rachel with Nighttime Mommy Reviews, and today we're going to be reviewing the all-new Instant Pot Pro. You guys, the Instant Appliance brand just released this Instant Pot, and you guys, I want to show you all the new features. There are so many cool features about this new Instant Pot, so we're going to review that. Now, you guys, if you aren't already subscribed, make sure you hit that subscribe button for new small kitchen appliance reviews. When they come out, I'm buying them, and I'm sharing the review on them to let you guys know what's going on with it. So if you like those types of videos, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Hit that like button if you like reviews on new products. But let's go ahead and get started. So here we have the 6-quart Instant Pot. They do make this in a 6-quart and an 8-quart. This machine or this appliance retails for $129.95 for the 6-quart, which is not far off from the regular Instant Pot, which I believe retails for $99.99. The 8-quart retails for $149.99, and for the 6-quart, it will hold 5.7 liters, and it weighs 13.01 pounds. In terms of the size, it is 13 inches in length, 12.7 inches in width, and then 12.8 inches in height. Now, there is a 3-prong plug here, which is pretty normal with the Instant Pot brand. It does have that ground plug. So what does it come with? You have the new Instant lid. I will show you guys that lid right now. You have your extra silicone ring, your trivet, and then they give you a little warning and also the manual, which I've gone through so that I can make the big points here for you to show you what this Instant Pot is all about. So the lid, everybody's been asking what's going on with this lid. Now we have, instead of the button for releasing the seal or venting, you have the seal icon right here and a vent. So if you want to seal your pot, you lift it up and then the pin will push up and let you know once it has come to pressure and it's sealed. Okay. When it is open, the pin is down and it's venting, right? So all the pressure is going to come out. So when you start cooking, always seal it. Okay, so let's get into the lid right here regarding the steam release. We have the steam release pipe, which is normal with all of the Instant Pots. The steam release valve, which is what we're used to seeing as a steam release valve. This is new, the steam release cover. So this goes over it to kind of disperse versus just going straight up. So we'll see how that works as well. So with this Instant Pot, you have this attachment. You may be saying, what is that for? This right here, and it just clicks out. You just push the tab back and it will pop out. This is for their quick cool technology. There's a little pocket that you add here, an attachment that you slide in here, and it allows it to quick release or naturally release a lot faster. They advertise up to 50% faster with releasing the pressure with using that technology. I'm going to have a separate video on that. I did not realize this until after I decided to start recording, so that is why we're going to do another video on it. But this is where you would add that attachment. I do want to mention for the quick cool tray, it is sold separately. It is $9.99 on their Instant Appliance site. I'll have the link for it in the description. Now, the nifty part of the Instant Pot Pro is that you have a pot that is flat on the bottom. If anybody remembers the other Instant Pots, it kind of was curved in the center and all of the liquid would fall to the sides until you had it just enough where it would cover everything. It's flat. It's completely flat. So it's going to make sauteing so much easier. Not only that, but you have handles on the side so that removing your pot is so much easier. With other Instant Pots, you had to, you know, kind of grab rags and, you know, lift out carefully. Now you have the handles or the convenience of handles to pull it out. And it has these little silicone covers on here So hopefully it doesn't get too hot. Now, this can be used on the stovetop, and it is stovetop and oven safe up to 450 degrees Fahrenheit, okay? And it can be used on electric, ceramic, gas, or even an induction cooktop, all right? Now, there are fill line indicators. They still let you know what is the max PC, the max PC line. Similar to all the other Instant Pots here, we have the condensation cup. Now, you guys, believe me, when you use or cook anything with a lot of liquid, this is needed. I cannot tell you how many times I have forgotten to put the cup there, and then I have liquid all behind the unit. So definitely important. Let me get that back on here. Oh, it slides in now. So this just slides in. I'll show you. So it slides out. And there's little notches right here to push it back in. Just slide that in place. And that's the condensation cup. Go to the front of the unit. Now, there is still a spot for the lid to add your lid. Now, on other Instant Pots, it was right here where the handles were. Now, they made sure that they angled the top here so that you can put your lid right in place right there. So there's still a spot, you guys. You can still put your lid on the base of the pot whenever you're cooking, stirring. Let's say you're using the saute mode. You can still put your lid right here and it rests perfectly. Okay, so how do you cook with it? What's going on with this new Instant Pot? Let me show you. Now, when you let's say you press pressure cook, right? We want it to be custom unless you wanted to use one of their preset settings. There is chicken, sterilized, pasta, beef, soup, egg, or beans that you can use, or you can do custom. You just have to press the button for custom, which is the first option. Then you select your pressure, high or low. You can select low or high. I'm gonna stick with high. Then you are given the option to amend the time. So you can do 1 minute increments. Keep going, whichever. After you select that, you get to decide whether you would like a vent reminder. You can have that off, set to 5 minutes or 10 minutes. Then you can click start and it will start. Now the lid is off, so it won't do much. It'll preheat. There's a preheating menu, cooking, and keep warm. So it's a status menu, essentially. So once it's preheating, you'll see the icons get grow. Then when it's cooking, same for when it's done and it's on keep warm, because it will shut off after a certain time period of it keeping it warm. So I'll select off. Next, for rice and grain, you have three options: custom, white rice, and brown rice. For steam, it's just custom, and you can choose the temperature between high and low. For saute, you have the five levels of heat along with high and low. So if you want to do the custom, you just move the dial there and it will flash. For slow cook, you have custom, chicken, beef, soup, and beans. For sous vide, you have chicken, custom, beef, and egg. For yogurt, it's just the custom setting. And for bake, you have custom, cheesecake, and bread. Okay, so with the saute function, now the display will say hot to let you know that you're ready to cook and it's heated up, whereas the other one did not. But the cool thing about this Instant Pot Pro is that whereas previously you just had one setting for heat, now you can bring the dial to the right, and I don't know if you guys can see that. Oh, you can. It says custom. If you click on it, you have five levels of heat, similar to your stovetop. So you can do one, which is the lowest heat, typical for simmering, and five for the highest heat. You just select it, select the time that you're going to be sauteing, select start, and once it's ready, the display will say hot across the screen to let you know. The keep warm button also has some changes here with this new Instant Pot Pro. You have three settings. You can do high, custom, or low. If I select custom, you can select the temperature that you would like it to be on. So it goes as high as 100 and, oh, looks like 194 degrees Fahrenheit, and the lowest is 144 degrees Fahrenheit. Once you select it, you can select your time. So the way to select it is by pressing the dial. You can select your time. Select start, and you'll see the keep warm icon will flash, and it's ready to go. The next feature of the Instant Pot Pro is that you can save up to 5 of your favorite recipes or settings on the Instant Pot Pro. Now, to do that, all you're going to do is select the function that you want. So if, let's say you like pressure cooking, and you typically do the custom, you like low pressure for this case, and you typically do 45 minutes. Okay, so I'll put the reminder on for 5 minutes. Once you have your settings in place, you're going to hold the favorite button, kind of like the cars in the old days for your favorite radio station. You'll see it say set one. Now click cancel and turn on favorite one. You see it saved my setting, low, 45 minutes, and the 5 minute reminder. That is how you would do it. Now, if you want to remove that setting and let's say change it, I'm going to click cancel. I'll do rice and grain, do white rice because you can choose between white rice and brown rice. I'm going to raise the pressure to high, raise the temperature or time to 14 minutes. Let's say the reminder for 5 minutes. I'm just going to hold it again for 3 seconds. And now it's set the setting. All you have to do is just wait for it to say set one. Then if I ever click it again, now it's back to the rice. And you can do that with all of the functions or all of the favorites. To use your favorite, all you have to do is select your favorite icon and click start, and you're good to go. So to test out this new steam feature, I have here 3 cups. We're going to do that water test. 3 cups of water. All right. I made sure that the vent is sent to seal, so now it's on sealing or sealed, and I'm going to select pressure cook custom. I want it on high temperature or high pressure, 5 minutes, no reminder, and select start. And then we'll see how it releases pressure. It just finished. I'm going to go ahead and click valve release. So it's pretty nifty that it's not going to just shoot up straight into the air. Now that cap or that cover disperses it, and it's so much more quieter. That's pretty nice. Now I can't wait to get my hands on the Quick Cool technology to test that out. That'll be another video, so make sure you hit the subscribe button for that. But that is really neat. Okay, so to turn the sound off, you have to make sure that the Instant Pot is off itself. It cannot be done while it is on. So you're going to hold the dial, and you can do 2 things with this. You can change the unit of temperature from Celsius or from Fahrenheit to Celsius. So you see that? I'm going to leave it on Fahrenheit. And then here is where you can select sound on or sound off. I'm going to select sound off. Now, the sound will stay on for safety and error messages. Those are the 2 things that cannot be turned off. So I'm going to turn that off. Oh, I think I already turned it off. Perfect. Okay. So I'll hit cancel, and that is how you would do it. So overall, my review of the Instant Pot Pro is really, it seems like Instant Pot or Instant Appliances, they added all of the best features and put them all into one pot You know, we have the Instant Max, which has the display here. The Instant Evo has the quick cool technology here where you can add that attachment. There's so many cool features that were added. You know, your sous vide, all of the functions are built into this one pot. I can say that this Instant Pot is definitely a game changer in terms of the safety features. The sill cover is a huge point. I cannot wait to test the quick cooling technology. I'm waiting for that in the mail. I rushed it. Hopefully it gets here soon enough so I can make that video for you guys and test it out to let you know if it really is truly a lot faster to release the pressure, because that is also a game changer there. Now, I love the features. I love how sleek it is compared to the original Instant Pot that I have. So I will show you. I'm gonna put this on the side so you can see how sleek and fancy this looks compared to the other one. This is one of their basic models. I have the Instant Pot Duo Nova. This is my main Instant Pot, and now I'm changing it and it's going to be substituted for this Instant Pot Pro. I just love how you can customize so many things on the Instant Pot Pro, and really for $20 it doesn't make a huge difference. And I actually found it on sale. It just came out and I found it on sale for their Prime Day sale. Amazon Prime, they had that Prime Day, and I found it on sale for $99. Now you guys, if you're not in my Amazon deal finder group, I post deals on Amazon, coupons, codes. Make sure you check the description box. I will have the link for that group. It's on Facebook. Right now, I post daily deals every single day in my Amazon deal finder group. So make sure you find that link in the description box. But the price for the price point, I love it. It doesn't make a huge difference, or it wasn't a huge difference in price. And you get so many features with this, and I love how you can customize everything. So my overall review of it is, I mean, I love it. If you guys want to see more videos, make sure you let me know if there's anything new you guys would like me to test. Let me know in the comments. But if you're not subscribed, make sure you hit that subscribe button for more small appliance reviews. When they come out, I buy them, I test them out, and I let you guys know what I think. So let me know in the description box what you guys think. But until next time, have a great night.